Chances are, 'cause I wear a silly grin the moment you come into view. Chances are you think that I'm in love with you.
Why do we do this to ourselves? We do this over and over and over and over again. Round and round we go. We're all just going round in circles. If one equals one, then I come so much out it hurts you. The worst truth, the fact is this, who actually self-inflicted. You've only got yourself to blame, the whole thing empty stitches. Still be right on, let bygones be bygones, 'cause all we want is love.
This is my third cup of coffee of the day so far, so I'm either about to get really fucking excited or really depressed. So I'm excited for us to go on that journey together. Have I even said hello yet today? Hi, how are ya? How are the kids? Welcome back to the Paris Diaries. I'm having a very chill Sunday today. I've honestly been so shattered from doing French lessons like every day. I also was struck down with tonsillitis this week. It was so grim, like waking up and your throat feels like you swallowed a razor blade. It's the worst way to start your day. You know when you're ill and then you have that one day where everything just absolutely peaks and you think there is no recovering from this. And then after that, everything gets better. That was like 2 days ago. And so today, I actually feel fine. So today I'm back to being a semi-normal human being. That's good. I just met up with an internet friend, Elena, who has just moved to Paris for a month, which is so exciting. And I feel like we have very similar attitudes towards like content creation. So it was really, really nice to chat with her. And now I'm back home and I'm gonna read to the end of this book, Lonely Castle in the Mirror. I bought this for a video and I mostly bought it because I love Japanese literature, but I'm not gonna lie, it has been a slow burn and it did sort of plunge me into a bit of a reading slump, but it's really picking up like in the final third. And so I think that I've got a storm coming. I think that the final 100 pages are gonna be quite good. And I don't really know how I feel about slow burn books where you have to really earn the ending. Like, is it good writing to make 200 pages incredibly dull and boring and then 100 pages of action? I don't know. Because honestly, if I wasn't reading this for a video, I probably would have just put it back on the shelf and given up. I don't know, I think that the ability to write concisely is a very underrated talent. So anyway, this is where I'm gonna be for the foreseeable, and I'll catch up with you in a bit. Sorry, I just realized I'm wearing jeans in the house on a Sunday, like a freaking psychopath. That needs to change immediately. You know what's so funny is that my mum came to visit and she phoned me a few days before asking me if I needed anything, like from home. And I was like, no, I've got everything I need, all good, don't worry about it. And then for the next few days, I kept thinking, God, I'm so annoyed I didn't ask her to bring some like comfy joggers for me because I didn't bring any with me to Paris. And then she turns up, opens her suitcase and is like, oh, I thought you might want these. My comfy joggers. Are you kidding me? She just had that like maternal instinct. She knew what I needed. You know, my favorite story about my mum is that when I was born, the number one song in the UK was You Say It Best When You Say Nothing At All by Ronan Keating. And my mum said she used to just sit there with me as a baby in her arms, sobbing, because she was like, you're my firstborn child and you can't say anything at all. But as your mother, I know exactly what you need. So she was like, you do say it best when you say nothing at all. And so that song just always really reminds me of my mum. Anyway, I now have joggers on and I'm gonna finish this damn book, even if it kills me. Okay, update. It was actually really good. The ending of this book, I think, could be a bit of a tearjerker for some people. Not for me, obviously, because I'm hard as nails, but it's really emotional. So interesting. This has been a massive seller in Japan and I'm glad I read it, but I don't necessarily know if I would like recommend it to people because the reading experience was mostly quite boring. Not gonna lie. It literally gets so dark so early these days, like winter is here. I feel like I opened my eyes to wake up like 5 minutes ago and it's already dark again. But I forgot to tell you, I actually made a purchase. It wasn't these sweets, but they are really good. It was actually this. It's from Samaritaine, which is like a luxury department store, I guess. And I thoroughly enjoyed myself in there. In fact, maybe too much. I said to myself, right, I only came here with two suitcases and they were full. So logistically, it is a real issue if I buy things and yet, here we are. But you know what? It's good fun, isn't it? So anyway, I was speaking to the guy who works in there and he said that they just opened a new part of the shop, which is dedicated to up-and-coming designers, especially French designers. And so I bought a t-shirt from one of them. Look, let me show you. The brand is called Drôle de Monsieur. Pardon the French accent, but I think that translates to funny sir, something like that. Anyway, it just is literally, it's a plain t-shirt. And then the back has this funky like skiing design on it. And then I'm pretty sure this says like funny this winter. Cet hiver? I know I'm gonna get roasted for my French accent in the comments. I'm learning, I'm trying. Please be nice to me, I'm very sensitive. Anyway, I just thought that was really funky and I tried it on and it fits like a glove. Honestly, right, you know when you try something on and it's like they made it for you? I normally wouldn't say things like this because I just know I'm gonna wear this in a future video and people are gonna watch it like, that is horrible on you. So if you do think that when you see me wearing this, keep it to yourself, all right? But that was my little purchase. By the way, when I used to work in retail, my mom taught me how to fold like this so that you do it all in one easy motion. Listen, I'm domesticated. Someone husbanded me up. And now I think I'm gonna heat up some pasta that I made yesterday. When I say made, I mean I like boiled it. And do my French homework.
Le bus n'est pas ici. Nous devons attendre le bus.
So, funny story, there was a delivery driver, like, standing right outside my window just here for ages, and he had, like, the sound effects all on his phone. And you know the noise that an iPhone makes where it's, like, typing? I could just hear that, but it felt really close to me, so I was like, is someone in my flat sending a text? But anyway, then realised he was standing outside. What has freaked me out about that is that if I could hear him typing from in here, then everyone on the street can hear me playing and singing along to Taylor Swift's new album, specifically All Too Well, 10 minute version, Taylor's version from the vault. So that's given me a lot to think about because I belt that. You're gonna tell me that you don't sing your frickin' heart out when she says you call me up again just to break me like a promise, so casually cruel in the name of being honest? Because let me tell you, I'm singing that like I'm Adele at Wembley. Also, I posted this on my YouTube community tab. Underrated feature of YouTube, I have to say. I don't know if anyone noticed, but in the All Too Well music video, there's like a bunch of books. Sorry, short film, not music video. Have some respect, jeez. Anyways, in the short film, there's loads of books, but they're all turned over, like they're all turned upside down so you can't see the covers. And my theory is that Blondie knew that I'm unhinged and I would have read every single one for a video. And she said, I'm gonna save you the effort. They don't mean anything. They are not Easter eggs. But I know all too well that I would have done that. Anyway.
Tu dois attendre ici.
You have to wait here. Hey. Guys, what the fucking fuck is going on here? What? Let's just say my feet are chilly because that has knocked my socks off. I'm just celebrating with some very fresh homemade pasta from the supermarket. Oh, I hope I don't have like pasta sauce around my lips because that is an ick, isn't it? I think that's the worst one. I don't want to collectively give you all the ick. I'm actually really devastated and gutted because I've just realized that the gym closes early on a Sunday. So now I can't go, which is, you know, just so heartbreaking, so sad.
He's actually really pleased.
Siri, stop exposing me, Siri.
Go to the gym then, you lazy shit.
Why is my Siri saying this to me? How do I reset it?
Fatty.
Okay, I'm done now.
Fuck you.
Oh, I'm crying. So instead of going to the gym, I'm gonna go and get drunk. By the way, there's Notre Dame. That's cool, but my friend Manny is actually in Paris. Jesus, what was that? My friend Manny is in Paris with his mom, and so they've just gone out for dinner, and now, that, by the way, that's a boat. I know it looks like a UFO was about to abduct me, but it's a boat down there. Anyway, he's out for dinner with his mom. I'm gonna go meet him for a drink afterwards. I'm hoping places are open late on a Sunday. I really don't know, but I'm very happy about it. Oh, Paris, you are beautiful. Right, I found Manny. There he is. I was just having drinks with a view, with McDonald's.
It's a beautiful McDonald's.
When in Paris. Okay, I'm just walking home and I'm traumatized. So I just had a bloody meet and greet with the whole cast of Ratatouille. Jesus. So I've just done an accidental bush tucker trial on my walk home. And also, I was just doing a little self-assessment on the French I used tonight. And I realized that I asked for a vase of wine rather than a glass. So that's good. Luckily he served it in a glass and not a vase, but the vase honestly would have been fine. But we're working on it, you know, these little things. And now my friends, I'm ending the vlog in the same way that I started it, by eating a baguette with jam on it. And that's on good storytelling. It's like 1 a.m. on a school night, gotta be up bright early for another week of French class. I did my homework earlier. This is my little workbook. And actually, it was rowdy in that bar tonight. Like, the person behind us just kept falling off her chair. There was a fight. Two people were like inside, just swinging each other around. I genuinely thought they were gonna smash the window of the bar. But I really love sitting outside under heaters and people watching. Immaculate vibes, love it a lot. Anyway, I'm gonna end the vlog because I feel like I'm just rambling. But I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that you are having a wonderful day. And you know what? I might put this video live on a Sunday so that we can all like live the Sunday vibes together. So let me know in the comment section how you're spending your Sunday. I hope you're having a nice one and I will catch you soon at some point. Probably. Yeah, no, I will. Okay, bye! I couldn't reach. Bye!